leader, Kurt Dowd of the House, and he will be the majority leader in 2014.
I'm gonna hold this as well. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
This is very nice to be in a room of smiling, friendly faces after spending a week in St. Paul. Thank you for having me, and thanks for, I know we're getting to the end of your day here too, so I won't bore you too much, but I'll give you a little update on what we're facing in St. Paul and a couple of other things. You know, we're not dealing with, first of all, maybe I'll finish introducing myself. I'm Representative Kurt Dowd. I was first elected to the legislature 2 years ago. I represent a district about 50 miles northwest of here that includes St. Francis, Zimmerman, that area. So northern Anoka County, southern Isani County. We are not dealing with people in the legislature who think very logically, so that's probably the biggest challenge that we've got. You know, obviously our biggest thing that we need to accomplish this session is to pass a balanced budget. There's a wide range of opinions on how to do that from the two sides. The Democrats obviously are back to their old tricks of increasing taxes. We like to harken back to the conversation that we had between ourselves 2 years ago and with the voters. And frankly, you know, the conversation we had with the governor at that time was, and we were dealing with a $6.2 billion deficit at that time. But we said, you know, this isn't the time to raise taxes. That's going to hurt Minnesota's economy. What we need to do is get government out of the way, let Minnesota's economy grow, and ultimately we'll accomplish what we need. And so we balanced the budget. After a 20-day government shutdown, the governor came to our point of view and said, okay, we'll try it your way. And I remember him exactly saying that, we'll try it your way. Now we look back after 2 years on what we accomplished. We balance the budget without raising taxes, and we actually have $3 billion of surplus revenue right now. $3 billion of revenue. And why did that happen? Because we got government out of the way. We didn't increase taxes. The economy grew, and the economy created jobs, and the state saw more revenue. Now, we don't have extra money laying around in St. Paul because the Democrats, prior to that, had left us with zero in the budget reserves and zero in the cash flow account. So we've refilled those. We also inherited a $1.7 billion shift to education. We've paid half of that back now and are working on paying the rest of it back. But once that stuff happens, what we need to do is actually cut taxes. That's what's going to make Minnesota more competitive. That's what's going to attract job creators into Minnesota. We actually need to cut taxes. But the governor is doubling down now. Democrats control all of state governments. We haven't seen it in 22 years, and there's a lot of responsibility that goes with that. But their plan now, and they've come up with the solution, which is increased taxes, and now they're trying to make the case for the problem. So they're laying out their case on why we need to raise taxes, and we are doing everything we can to fight them. Right now, when we started the session, I might go a little bit long, I hope. I won't go too long, but when we started the session, we had a $1.2 billion deficit, and the Democrats love talking about a deficit because it makes it sound like the state needs more money. We got our budget forecast last week, basically said that we had a $627 million budget deficit, so it's getting better. Minnesota's economy is recovering, we're headed in the right direction. Increasing taxes right now is exactly the wrong move, but they're proposing, and the governor's initial proposal was $3.7 billion in tax increases. He's since revised that to down to about $2.4 billion. But still, the answer is we've got to raise taxes. And the same thing that we learned 2 years ago is true today. If we increase taxes, we're going to hurt Minnesota's economy, we're going to make Minnesota less competitive for job creators, and it's going to hurt middle-class families. And that's really the problem. The House Caucus put out a flyer, and I think we've got copies of this. We may not have enough for everybody. This is my fourth stop of the day. And this thing actually went over pretty well. We put it out a week ago in our press availability. Basically says Dayton's tax plan is just the tip of the iceberg for middle-class Minnesotans. And above the waterline, it shows the tax proposals that the governor's been proposing. Below the waterline is all the stuff that's in process right now in the legislature. And on the back side, you can see the bills that correspond with everything on the front side. So if you want to get a copy of that, you can also pick that up on our Twitter feed, on our Facebook page, on the website for the House Republican Caucus. So go ahead and take a look at that. You know, the interesting takeaway for me on the budget has been 2 years ago the governor called our budget an all-cuts budget. And today I'll call his budget an all tax budget. $22 of tax increases for every dollar in cuts, an all tax budget. We created more revenue in our all cuts budget than he's proposing to pick up in his all tax budget. He's got the wrong, he's headed in the wrong direction for Minnesota. And at the bottom of the poster, it basically says that Democrats' taxes will sink Minnesota's economy. So lastly, I just want to thank you for all the support that you gave to us in the last election cycle. Obviously, it didn't turn out as we had hoped, but we are focused like a laser beam on 2014 and getting us back in the majority. We've got two things that we absolutely need to accomplish in 2014. The governor's race, and we need to get the House back in the majority. The Senate's not up now for 4 years, but we've got to put a backstop against the runaway tax increases and spending of the Democratic Party. And we know that when it comes to it in 2014, you guys will be by our side. So we thank you for everything that you did for us in the last cycle. And we look forward to working with you to regain the majority in the Minnesota House and put an end to the taxing and spending in St. Paul. So thank you for coming out today, and thanks for all your support.
Thank you.